Yes, my dear students, welcome back for third session. I am confident that you have understood the previous two sessions. In the first session, I have explained these letters and their functions, parts of speech, articles. First session is over. In the second session, I have explained verbs. In this third session, I am going to explain the concept of tense. Tenses. Tense means what? Time. How many types of times are there? Three. What are those three? Today, yesterday, tomorrow. Today, whole day. Yesterday to thousand of years duration, yesterday past tense. Today is present tense. Yesterday to lakhs of years back or ago, past tense. Tomorrow to thousand of years in advance, future tense. I am not going to the maximum level. I will control myself to help you to understand the concept for the sake of first PC and the second PC. Now I am going to explain this concept, tenses. Tenses are three types. Okay, you know it better. I know it better than you know it better. But I will try whether you are going to learn any new concept in my teaching or explanation today. Tenses means time. How many types of times are there? Three. Tenses, three. One is present tense, another one past tense, another one future tense. Present tense, today. Past tense, yesterday. Future tense, tomorrow. Enough. Next. I have written here, three. I have framed three boxes, nine boxes totally. I will explain. It is a new formula. You have to come to that level to understand this concept in this manner itself. See, I go to college, base sentence. I am going to college, second base sentence. I have gone to college, third base sentence. These all are sub sentences. I will explain first. Let us understand. I don't need those all bookish rules. Simple present tense, present continuous, present perfect continuous, simple past, past continuous, past continuous, simple future, future continuous. Unnecessary. Those days are over. Those days are over. I will never use any single bookish method rule. That is, that those days are over. That chapter saga is over. My concept is totally different. I go to college. I am going to college. I have gone to college. What is the meaning of these three base sentences which fall under present tense? First, I will explain the meaning in Kannada because I must make you to understand the meaning of this one first in Kannada. Later you can understand each and every sentence. Now, I go to college. You know the Kannada meaning. Nanu college ge hoguttene. That's all. Action has not started. I am going to college. Nanu college ge hogutta iddene. Action begins. Action is continuing, but it is not over yet. I have gone to college. Nanu college ge hogiddene. Listen, listen, please understand. I will go slowly itself. I go nanu hoguttene. I am going hogutta iddene. I have gone hogiddene. All these three fall under present tense. Today or tomorrow, it is not a main point now. Let us understand the structure first. Once more, I go, I am going, I have a. Similarly, I take a pen. Nanu penu tegedukollutene. I am taking a pen. Nanu penu tegedukolluta iddene. Action has started, but it is not over yet. I have taken a pen. Nanu penu tegedukollutene. For example, I take this chopstick. I am taking, I have taken. Next, I will keep, I am keeping, I have kept. Tegedukolluttene, tegedukolluta iddene, tegedukolluttene. In this order, listen. I tell, heduttene. I am telling, hedutta iddene. I have told, heduttene. Have you understood? Please, this playback, this one, but please understand. Play this one once more. Please understand. Once or twice, store those things in your mind forever. This will be helpful. Okay. Now, what is the verb? For example, what is the power or strength of verbs or helping verbs? Means, for example, now I go into college. Now tell me. Is there any tense to this one? I go into college today or yesterday or tomorrow? Not possible. Why? Helping verb is not here. ING form must take B form helping verb. That is why I am going present tense. I was going past tense. I will be going future tense. It is why verbs are very important to know the time sequence. When the action is taking place, whether it is today or yesterday or tomorrow, whether the action is taking place in the present tense or past tense or future tense, verbs are important. Now, it is called V1. Simple present tense. Action will begin. That's all. Here, I am going. V form plus V1 plus ING. We don't teach V4, V5, V6, V7, V8, unnecessary blunder, bluff. We don't like those systems. We have our own systems and methods and tricks and ideas. Now listen, understand. V1 plus S, V1 plus ING. Now, what is V1? Yes, comes. Comes means V1 plus yes. Now, coming is V1 plus ING. I never use V4, V5, V4, V5, V6, V7. It is not like other any other thing. It is why comes V1 plus yes. Goes, V1 plus S. Loves, V1 plus S. Gives, V1 plus S. Next, giving, V1 plus ING. Coming, V1 plus ING. Laughing, V1 plus ING. V1 plus ING, V1 plus S. V1, V2, V3. These are main ones we don't follow. Those are the orthodox method. Now, V1. Here, V form plus V1 plus ING. Here, I have gone. Have form plus V3. Please, this is very important. If you can understand this concept here, under these boxes, then only you can understand those past tense and future. Once more. V1, V form plus V1 plus ING. Have form plus V3. Compulsory form. Have form plus V3 or B form plus V3. Have form plus V3, active voice. B form plus V3, passive voice. It is the law of English. Now, listen. Next steps. What is this? I, we, you, they. Now, Rama and Krishna. Rama Krishna means a single person. Rama and Krishna means two persons. That means what? Plural noun, not singular noun. Rama, singular noun. Krishna, singular noun. Rama and Krishna, plural noun. That means I go to college, we go to college, you go to college, they go to college, Rama and Krishna go to college. That means these are noun and pronoun. Take only be one. This. Okay, have you understood? I plus we plus you plus they plus Rama and Krishna, all these nouns and pronouns take only be one. And then we go, now go to TV. You go, Nenu hogo, Nenu hogo. They go, avaru hogutare. Rama and Krishna hogutare. Hogtare idare. No confusion at all. Yes. Next. He, avanu hogutane. She, avaru hogutare. Rama hogutane. He, she plus Rama. These three noun and pronoun come under one group. These all come under one group. This is the formula. Once more. These all noun move 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 come under one group. 1, 2, 3 come under one group only under this, in this box only, not later on in other boxes. Now, my point is, he go to college correct? She go to college correct? Rama go to college correct? I feel that you are going to learn this one correctly and better and perfectly. He go, Ram goes. So, we one plus yes must be there. When we are using the pronouns I, he, or she, or singular noun, I am not taking one particular name. Whatever the singular noun is there, it must be not only V1 but V1 plus yes. It is the method what you should remember forever. He go to college. No. He goes to college. He comes to college. He gives the book. He laughs in the class. Okay? He takes the pen. He eats some fruits. In this item, my dear students, this he and she singular noun will never take simple V1. V1 plus yes is required for he and she and Rama when we are saying. Now, he goes, avanu hogutane. Hogtane? No. He, she goes, avalu hogutane. Rama goes, Rama hogutane. That's all. You write any name? Rama goes, Krishna goes, Mukunda goes, Radha goes, all will go, but not single. Now, I am going to college, yeah, is here. But he, she, Rama, is required. He am going, I is going, totally blunder English. Please understand. He is going, she is going, Rama is going. That means what? I am going, hogutayidene. He is going, avanu hogutayidane. Hogidene, no. Action is going on. She is going, avalu hogutayidane. Rama is going, Rama hogutayidane. Okay, next. We, you, they, Rama and Krishna, plural noun. Here, Rama, singular noun. We are going, see, one. Here is, see, Yam is a. How many words have I written previously? 5 be formed verbs. Here three are under present tense. Was were under past tense. Now, I am going Yam. He is going is. We are going are. So, these three, they must be compulsory be formed plus ing or be formed plus V3. How formed plus V3. Now, we are going, you are going, they are going, Rama and Krishna are going. One concept. Next concept. I have gone to college. Nanu college ke hogiddene. Okay. We, you, they, Rama and Krishna have gone. That means we have gone. Nanu hogiddene. You have gone. No, nenu hogiddeya. Or nenu hogiddeve. They have gone. Avaru hogiddare. Rama and Krishna ಹೋಗಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಹೋಗಿದ್ರು ಡಿಫರೆಂಟ್ ಹೋದರು ಡಿಫರೆಂಟ್ ಹೋಗ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ ಡಿಫರೆಂಟ್ 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 ನೋ ಕನ್ಫ್ಯೂಷನ್ ಪ್ಲೀಸ್ ಐ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಗಾನ್ ನಾನು ಹೋಗಿದ್ದೇನೆ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಗಾನ್ ನಾವು ಹೋಗಿದ್ದೇವೆ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಹಿ ಶಿ ರಾಮ ಸಿ ಹಿ ಶಿ ರಾಮ ಒಂದು ಹಿ ಶಿ ರಾಮ ಒಂದು ಹಿ ಶಿ ರಾಮ ದಟ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ third person singular plus singular noun fall under bandhu yes third person singular he she this is singular noun fall under bandhu so has should be here he has gone avan hogiddane she has gone avan hogiddane rama has gone rama hogiddane that means what present as this hogutene hogta idene hogiddene present tense yes you take some time and note down my request is that you have to note down these all sentences then practice it well later only use switch over to past tense until then don't go to past tense please practice these sentences 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 sentences are there in this boxes please practice this one now itself further after understanding this one thoroughly then switch over to past tense now I will continue with the past tense now past tense means what yesterday hundreds of years ago there is no time limit now I went to college when means what oh there past tense somewhat easy comparing to this one why we want to say yes this is somewhat irritating almost all many students now I went oh they you take any noun or pronoun singular or plural all nouns all pronouns stay only we to come and play there is no variation at all I went man oh they we went now oh they oh they went our hodaru rama went rama hoda Rama and Krishna, singular, plural, I, we, third person singular, all will, this is common to all noun, singular, plural, pronouns and nouns. This is the law of English. Next, first I will explain the meaning of these basic sentences. I went, nanu, ho, de, work is over. I was going, nanu, ho, kukta, idde. Action is not over. Action was taking place in the past itself. We don't know whether the action is over or not. We are not responsible for that one. Now, I was going, nanu, ho, kukta, idde. I had gone, ho, ki, idde. Ho, de, no. Ho, ki, idde. Past tense, past tense, past tense. Once more. I went, nanu, ho, de. I was going hokta idde I had gone hokidde again come back otherwise it is somewhat irritating and confusing I go nanu hoguttene I went nanu hode I am going nanu hokta iddene I was going nanu hokta idde I have gone hokidde I had gone nanu hokidde action two are over one was going on action is over here actions are not over it is a concept of present tense and the past tense yes practice understand these three sentences later after learning this one itself you can understand remaining six lines now this is over now what is the word he she rama see what that means I also falls under this group I was going he was going she was going Rama was going singular all singular takes here was here all singular takes is except I is so special I will explain when you come to college next I was going nanu hogta idde he was going avanu hogta idda she was going avadu hogta iddalu Rama was going Rama hogta idda Sheila was going Sheila hogta idda Jalani was going. Jalani hoguta iddaru. It is the meaning of this one in the past tense. Next. Now, we, you, they say plural, singular, plural, plural, plural. Always plural, noun and pronoun, pair, were. Always singular, noun and pronoun, pairs, were. It is a formula. So, we were going. Now, hoguta iddaru. They were going, you were going. Nivu hoguta idri. Hoguta idri no, hoguta idri. They were going. Avaru hoguta iddaru. Hoguta iddare present tense. Hoguta iddaru past tense. Next, Rama and Krishna were going. That means it is called plural noun. Plural noun were, singular noun was. It is the concept of past tense. Next. See, here no problem. I have gone, no nanu hoki idde. For take anything, we had gone, they had gone, she had gone, he had gone. Here, I went, they went, she went, Rama went, Rama and Krishna went. Here also, I had gone, we had gone, they had gone, he had gone. Everything had gone indeed for all noun and pronouns, singular and plural, for each and everything had gone. Now form plus V3, form plus V1 plus ING, it is called V2. Once more, V2, V form plus V1 plus ING, have form plus V3, had plus V3 or have form plus V3, it is called V form plus V1 ING. Present tense, past tense, future tense. These are two are over. I will explain now future tense. See, future tense will not trouble us so much like present tense. I will go to college. Nanu college ge hoguveno. Hoguttene present tense. Hode past tense. Hoguveno future tense. For each and every noun and pronoun, singular, plural, for each and every subject, will plus V1, please. I will go to college, we will go to college, you will go to college, Rama and Krishna will go to college, he will go to college. Some great masters claim that he shall go to college, that is different, we don't need those all things. Those all have disappeared. What is required? He will go to college future. Future tense. Avanu hoguvano. Hogutane no no no. I will be going to college. Nanu hoguta irtini no no. Hoguta irve no. I will be going, we will be going, Rama will be going. For each and everything, same order. All subjects will take place, will plus V1. You don't memorize. Understand the concept very well. And store that one in your mind. I will be going, we will be going, Rama will be going, Krishna will be going, Rama and Radha will be going. Unnecessary. Whatever the subject it may be, it will take, will be, will plus V plus V1 plus ING. Once more. Will plus V plus V1 plus ING. Over. Will plus V1. Here also. I will have got future tense. Will plus R plus V3. So, this rule will never can be broken down. Broken. It cannot be removed. Have plus V3 compulsory. Nanu hogi iruvanu. Avanu hogi iruvanu. Avanu hogi iruvanu. This is the concept of future tense. Yes, I hope that all of you have understood. I will explain the summary in the end. In this session, for the next 15 minutes, I will explain some structures that never can be expected by anyone. Amazing English. I will not say anything about that one. First, I will complete this concept of tenses. Later, I will explain, not teaching, I will explain some concepts, amazing concepts. I will explain, please wait. Now, finally, there are three tenses, present tense, past tense, future tense, V1 form plus V1 plus ING, have plus V3, has plus V3, V2 was plus V1 plus ING, have plus V3. Here, will plus V1 will be V1 plus ING, will plus have plus gone. This is called tenses. Please, you practice this one. My dear students, if you have understood this concept, later only you can understand the next session. It is my sincere request to you. I appeal to you sincerely. Please practice this one very well. After understanding only, you can understand the next session, types of sentences. After understanding the types of sentences, you can understand type of questions, question tags. If you don't understand this one today itself, next session cannot be understood by you. It is why, my dear students, practice this one very well. You become thorough, anyhow, previous chat is available. It is why, please understand this one and practice it very well. Become thorough. Later, we will continue the sessions with this types of sentences, types of questions, and question tags. I will explain that one. Okay. Next, in this session, I will explain some different concept. My dear students, it is the first time I have taken this concept. I had this plan for several years, but I could not engage any class. I have 15 more minutes. I cannot start a new concept. It is why. Today, all of us are going to learn, realize how we are going to, how we have learned English. Here, title is Amazing English. I have written only 8 simple sentences. There is no new thing at all. First, I will read these all lines. Later, I will tell what is the question. What is the problem? I will say later. I will read these 8 lines to you. I am going to the college. I am learning the English well. May I know what is your name, please? Can you give me some money? Yes, I am not going to Bangalore today. I am in the bus. I went to a party last night, yesterday night. This is not my concept. My concept is, I will say, I will ask you now. Now, listen. First, you note down these all 8 sentences first. You pause the video. You note down these all 8 sentences. Later, I will put you one question. You pause the video. You note down or write these all 8 sentences. Later, I will put you one question. Yeah. Now, I hope all of you have written these 8 sentences. Okay. First question is, what are these sentences? These all are simple sentences. Okay. How many are correct? How many are wrong? Whether all 8 are wrong or all 8 are correct? It is my question. Once more. Out of 8 lines or sentences, how many are correct? How many are wrong? Note it down. Yes. Pause the video. Read the sentences and note these 8 sentences and note down the answer. How many are correct? How many are wrong? All are correct or all are wrong? It is the concept. It is not simple indeed. Surely. Now, I will start explaining the secrets in English. It will take you to the maximum level in English. We are using blunder and bluff English. I have watched so many people are using bluff and blunder English. What is correct English? Now, I will explain. Some people, some students may not agree with me, but the rules and regulations are given by our great masters. The rules and regulations are not created by me. I have not invented the previous methods, way of grammar teaching. It is my invention. I have discovered, not invented. I have not created, my great masters have created these all secrets. I have got that one for 15 years. I have read these all things for 15 years. I am giving it to you within 15 minutes. Now, I will show how bluffly, blindly we are using English, how badly we are using English. I will prove today. Okay, one by one. I am going to the college. Right or wrong?
Wrong.
Wrong. Why? I will explain. If you say it is a wrong sentence, it is a correct sentence. One way it is correct. Grammatically it is correct. What I am saying? Grammatically correct. Grammatically it is not wrong. You must understand this concept. This is correct sentence, but it is not correct sentence to you and to me. For you means student, for me means lecturers, for only both of us it is wrong. For all other human beings it is correct. How can one sentence become a correct sentence to some people? It is a wrong sentence to some people. Can you ever imagine in your life why is this correct only for some limited people? Why is it correct for so many people? Do you know this concept? We have used wrong sentences in our life, and how can we speak correctly? How can we write English correctly? We are committing great errors, mistakes unknowingly. I feel sometimes very sad while I see so many people are using so blunder, bluff, wrong English. Is there any one sentence on this entire planet in any other language that one sentence will be suitable to limited people, other sentence will not be suitable to other people? How is it possible in any other language on this entire planet? Yes. Now, I will explain it is why. Simply, I have given the title Amazing English. After explaining 5 sentences, I will give the other title. Now, I am going to the college. Okay. What is the meaning of to the college? What is the meaning of to college? We must understand. To the college is from to me to you. Why? I am coming here to teach you. You are coming to college to learn. You and I are connected to the academic learning process. I am the giver, you are the receiver. Okay. But to the college means, what is the meaning? From me. Our non-teaching staff, computer operators and this receptionists,
ayahs, peons, and this cleaners, all must say, I am going to the college. Only students and lecturers and principals and management must say, I am going to college. It is the law of English. If you say, I am going to the college, you are coming to college not for learning, only to assist the students and lecturers. Is it your job to do other things? Washing floors, cleaning other things, or supplying some other things? You are connected to the academy. I am connected to the academy. It is why you students and myself must say that I am going to college. If I say I am going to the college, I am not a lecturer. For example, I am an electrician, has come to the college. Okay, now he must say, I have come to the college. Why? He is going to repair some electrical problems. For me, for you, I am going to college. It is why only students and lecturers and principals and management must say, I am going to college. Remaining all people must say, I am going to the college. It is why one sentence has created two meanings. Yes? Think. Rethink. Analyze. Reanalyze. Read, reread. Watch the video several times. You go to any Google, internet, professors, whatever I say, that is the law. Means I have learned the laws, it is correct only. I can prove, no problem. It is the law, first law. You know one words, you must say, I am going to college, not going to the college. Others, whoever it may be, who are not teachers or principals or lecturers, they must say, I am going to the college. If any person is saying, I am going to the college, he is not a student or a lecturer at all. If a person says, I am going to college, he is a lecturer or a student of the college. It is the first law. Yes? It may look very strange, different and somewhat peculiar, but it is correct English. Yes, it is the law. I have not created this law. Our great masters have created this law. I have received, I have practiced, I am giving it to you. Yes, next one blunder is over. I am learning the English. Now tell me. It is correct or wrong? Yes. Some people say, I learn the English. Okay. I will take, I learn the English. Okay. Now, correct or wrong? Correct or wrong? Not it. You note down answer to each and every line after my explanation, tally it, compare it with my explanation and your written answer. Now, I learn the English correct or wrong? Tell me. You think takes so much time, you take hundreds of hours, whether you can change. Yes. Now, I learn the English, both are correct, but it is not correct for some people. It is correct for only some people, it is wrong for some people. Why? It is the problem in English. One sentence is correct to some people, it is not correct to many people. Yes? How? It is called amazing for the English. There are thousands of secrets. 3000 secrets are there in our history that cannot be solved by anybody, including myself. I have learned these all things from the great masters. It is why I am happy that I can give this one to you today. Now, what is the difference between I learn English? I learn the English. What?
Some people will say, I learn the English correct. I learn English is correct. I am learning the English is correct. Whatever it may be. My point is, what is the difference between the English and without the article the? We have memorized, we have by heart it, a, an, indefinite articles, the, definite articles, ha, ho, that these are over. That chapter or era period is over. We must think so many times, why should we use, why we should not use. Yes, you think, we think, it is the law of English. That is not created by me. Now, what is the difference between I learn the English, I learn English. What is the difference? Big difference. Yes. I learn English. Yes, you are learning our language, English. Then, what is the meaning of the English? It is not a language at all. The English is English people. American people and England people are called the English. That's all. I learn the English means you are learning the lifestyle of Americans or Britannians. British people. If you say I learn English, you are learning English language. This is the difference between the English and English. See, how many people do know this kind of difference between using the article without the article. Simply we have learned without analyzing anything. It is why I have taken this concept to prove that how blindly we have learned our English for so many years. Yeah, this is why. Now Albert, you must say, I learn English only, not I learn the English. So, I learn English is correct, I am going to college is correct. Yes. Now tell me, can your answer tell me this explanation? Yes. You take and repeat, no problem. Next. He is working hardly. Once more. He is working hardly. Means correct or wrong? If you say now one word, it is a wrong sentence. Means what is a wrong thing? You must explain. That means this is wrong at all. Hardly itself is wrong. What is the correct one? Why is it wrong? First you must understand. How can we correct this sentence? Hardly means what? Hard means what? Hardly means nil. Hard means full. This is the meaning. See, we feel, my son is working hardly. Papa, papa, papa. We feel very happy. Wow, your son is working very hardly. What kind of English are we using? We say that he is working hard, means he is doing nothing. He is not reading at all. It is a bluff. He is working hard, means he is doing nothing. He is working hard, means he is doing everything. That means he is working very hard, means he is reading very well. He is working hard, means he is not reading at all. One word will create so many differences. It is why, my dear students, we must become perfect in our language. Otherwise, we cannot. This is the biggest secret. These are the biggest secrets. I never took this one. Why means I did not have sufficient time. Moreover, many people may not agree with my points, but it is a law. It is not created by me. Yeah. Next, I will prove how blindly we are using English. How wrongly we are using English. Next point. This is wrong. This is hard, correct? Hardly is wrong. Hardly means I am I may agree with you. Hardly means I don't agree at all. This is I am working hard means I am working very much in it. I am working hardly means nothing. Nil and full. Hardly means nil. Hard means full. This is the difference between hardly and hard. Yes. Next point. May I know what is your name, please? okay, Andrew?
Please may not require. Okay. May I know what is your name?
Yeah. Correct or wrong?
Wrong means how is it wrong? Correct means I will prove that it is wrong. Yes. We have spoken this word several thousand times without knowing the correct meaning. Now, how to know? Understanding this concept will help you to score 5 marks in second PUC. Please. Understanding this sentence number 4 will help you to score 5 full marks in second PUC annual exam. It is linked to reported speech or indirect speech. Now, may I know what is your name? It is a wrong sentence. Great blunder mistake. How? Listen. May I know? It is a question or not? May I come? May I do? May I go? Correct or wrong? Full question. Now, what is your name? It is a full question or not? Full question. Then, how can you use 2 double questions in 1 single line? It is my point. How can you use 2 double questions in the same line? For example, he did not went anywhere. See, for example, to make you understand the concept, I am using this line. Oh, sorry, no question mark. I am sorry. He did not went anywhere. It is a correct sentence or wrong? Well, it is already in the past tense. This past tense we do is not required. It is when he did not go is correct, he did not went. How we are not using double past tense? Similarly, we never should use double questions in the same sentence. When there are 2 questions, means what is the correct sentence to make it as 1 question? We must learn. If you can learn this one, you are in advance, 2 years in advance. It is why, my dear students, I am so happy indeed that you are learning so excellent in English. Moreover, you are learning so easily, so excellently, and you are working very hard, not hardly. Some students may be working hardly, okay, but many students are working hard indeed. Now onwards, hardly is wrong. Hard is correct. I am going to college is correct. I am not going to the college. Going to the college means sleeping, eating and sleeping very well. Do you want to do that work at college? Yeah. Now, so what is the correct sentence? May I know, correct, what your name is? This is correct. Is should, may I know what is? No, 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 no. What your name is must come in the end. It will help you to understand in the second year reported speech exclusively under maximum level. Yes. Have I understood? May I know what your name is? Correct. May I know what is your name is? Totally wrong. Whether you agree with me or not, I don't bother. Why? It is a rule of English. It is not created by me. Method can be created, ideas can be created, our own rules, but it is the law of English. I have not created. There are 3000 sentences in my mind. I will give you a minute. Now, can you give me some money? Okay, Salpa Dudu Kortiya, Kannada. Correct. Wah. Can you give me some money? Oh, Radhika, can you give me some money? Oh, Krishna, can you give me some water? But what is the best English? It is totally wrong. This style sentences will take place in the indirect speech or reported speech. It is why my sincere request. I sincerely request you, my dear students, practice these all things. Correct your English. Next. Can you give me some money? Okay. Salpa dudu kortiya. Yen tappide? Ee master ge em English parala means? It is your wrong idea and opinion and decision. Now,
Can you give me somewhere? It is somewhat, I will say, I won't say very, by stamping my approval, it is correct, it is wrong also. But for some people it is correct, some people it is a wrong sentence, no problem. But what is the best sentence? I won't say that it is a wrong sentence, but it is wrong, correct, wrong only. But how to say it is correct, how to say it is wrong? Yes, you can you give me 20 rupees? It is okay. Specific amount should be mentioned. Can you give me 20 rupees? Can you give me some money? No, 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 no. Some money means it is indefinite amount, figure. It is by, for according to the great masters, it is not my opinion. I won't approve this answer, but they have told, means foreigners. Because of foreigners only, I have learned so many things. I would like to say that according to the other countries, English countries, foreign countries, can you give me any money? Not some money. Can you give me any money? Means give me some money. It is right. Can you give me some water also? According to them, not according to me. I won't approve this sentence. Can you give me any water? According to them, that is correct. According to me, what is correct, what is wrong? I don't wish myself to be involved in this concept. Can you give me any money is correct, but it looks very awkward and peculiar. But according to the foreigners, it is not correct. It is the wrong sentence. Can you give me any money? Can you give me some water? No, no, no. Can you give me any water? In the beginning, I too was surprised. I too have analyzed this one for several months. But anyhow, I cannot give my approval. I don't stamp. It is not my concept. But according to the foreigners, can you give me any money is correct. Why? Unspecified figure. It is the proof. But I won't approve. Next. Yes, I am not going to Bangalore. Oh, Bhima, you are not going to Bangalore today now. Yes, I am not going to Bangalore today. Whether it is a correct sentence or not? Yes? Think. It is a wrong sentence. Why? How? Why and how? Then this, which is the correct sentence? Think. Rethink. You think for several minutes. Others. Yeah. This is positive. It is negative. How can you mix sugar and salt? Is it possible? Similarly, it is sugar, it is salt. How can you mix them together? It is why? It is a blender. It is a bluff. Now, you must write, no. Even though a person is positive, you must say negatively. If you are going, yes, I am going to Bangalore. Please. Yes, I am going to Bangalore. Whether the person is positive or negative, yes, I am going to Bangalore. If you are not going, no. I am not going. No, comma. No full stop. No, comma. I am not going to Bangalore today. It is the correct sentence. Now tell me, where is our English? Where is real English? Yes? I too have practiced several times. Once upon a time, I was also like you, a small learner. I am also a learner now too. For several years also, I am a smallest, I am the smallest learner. Yes, no one words. No, I am not going to Bangalore. Yes, I am going to Bangalore. It is the concept of writing correct English. Next one. It is the great bluff master. Thousands and lakhs of people are using I am in the bus. Hey Ravi, where are you now? Hey man, I am in the bus. Hey Papi. Yes, but it is a wrong sentence. Wrong, wrong, wrong. Bluff. I am in the bus means different. I won't say that word. Okay. What is the correct sentence? Let us see. Listen. For your kind information, preposition itself is the greatest troubler to us. It is the toughest concept.
We can deal with all things, but devotion, no human being is perfect in this entire world.
This is also, it is also a wrong sentence. We must say, you may not agree with me, it is correct English. I am on the bus, not in the bus.
You may think, ಇದೇನಿದು ಬಸ್ ಒಳಗೆ ಇರ್ತೀವಿ ಇದ್ರೆ ಬಸ್ ಟಾಪ್ ಮೇಲೆ ಇರ್ತೀವಾ
ನೋ 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 ಐ ಆಮ್ ಆನ್ ದ ಬಸ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಆನ್ ಎ ಟ್ರೈನ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಆನ್ ಫ್ಲೈಟ್ ಏನ್ ಫ್ಲೈಟ್ ಅನ್ಕೊಂಡು ಬಿದೋಗಲ್ವಾ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಇಂಗ್ಲಿಷ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಇನ್ ಎ ಫ್ಲೈಟ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಇನ್ ಎ ಬಸ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಇನ್ ಎ ಟ್ರೈನ್ ತೂ 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 ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ರಾಂಗ್ ಇಂಗ್ಲಿಷ್ ಬ್ಲಫ್ 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 ಐ ಆಮ್ ಆನ್ ದ ಬಸ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಆನ್ ಎ ಫ್ಲೈಟ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಆನ್ ಎ ಟ್ರೈನ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಇನ್ ಎ ಟ್ರೈನ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಯು ಡೋಂಟ್ ನೋ ಎನಿ ಇಂಗ್ಲಿಷ್ ಅಟ್ ಆಲ್ You don't know English at all. Next one. I went to a party. It is also a wrong sentence. How I went to a marriage. Are you going to marry the other person? No, no. You went to attend that marriage. It is why I went to for a party. I went to for the marriage. It is a correct. For should be there. To is on. Here in is on. And should be there. It is called correct human being. I have given that title. The correct title is Correct Your English. It is the correct lesson. Okay, my dear students, I am so sorry that I have taken this toughest concept ever in my life. I have never taught. Please understand, there are such 3000 sentences with me. I can prove which are correct, which are not correct. It is over because we are running out of time. Please, in my next session, I will explain types of sentences and question tags, type of questions I will explain. Please practice. It may be important for you. It may not be important for you, but it is important for me. Why? It is my duty to teach you correct English. Practice this one. Have a nice day. Please practice the previous 2 sessions in the next session. If you have understood 2 current sessions only, you can understand the next session. I hope please enjoy. Have a nice day. Be healthy and happy. God bless you. Have a nice day.